Hey guys, this video is going to be a bit different from my typical tutorials. Over the past few weeks, I've been developing a new Excel add-in that transforms data into interactive charts. In this video, I want to share with you both my motivation behind building this add-in and also share what I've developed so far. Most importantly, I'm eager to hear your thoughts about this add-in. I would like to know if you would use it, what I could improve, and which features you would like to see included. But before I show you the add-in, let me briefly share why I decided to create it in the first place. My coding journey actually began with VBA. At work, I use VBA to automate many tasks and streamline my workflow. But then I stumbled across interactive charts created with Python, and I thought, how cool would it be if I could create those charts as well? That curiosity is what led me to Python. One of the first Udemy courses I took was on how to create interactive Python dashboards with Plotly and Dash. This also explains why some of my earliest YouTube videos were all about transforming Excel data into interactive charts using Plotly. However, at work, I often had to deal with messy Excel files. Just to convert the data into a suitable format to create Plotly charts took up a significant amount of time. More often than not, I found myself sticking with standard Excel charts instead. That is also one of the reasons why I created my first Excel add-in called My Tool Belt. With this add-in, you can quickly transform your Excel range into a pandas data frame. Once you have it in a pandas data frame, you can manipulate the data further or create charts using Plotly, for example. However, when I save Plotly charts as HTML files, I noticed the file size was often more than 3 megabytes. This was too big to easily share multiple charts in a simple email to my manager. Then I came across the PyEcharts library, which I also covered in another video. I liked PyEcharts because their animations are great right off the box and the size of the HTML file is very small, often just a few kilobytes. But PyEcharts doesn't naturally work with pandas data frames, so you have to do a bit more coding to make the charts. That is why I decided to make an Excel add-in. I want a simple user interface and use PyEcharts behind the scenes to create great looking visuals. Okay, so that was a little bit about why I decided to start this project. Now let me show you what I've developed so far. Keep in mind, this isn't the final version of the add-in. I'm still actively working on it. So the add-in is called Grafly. When I click on the charts button, this form appears. Here I can enter the name of the HTML file, select the chart type, and optionally provide a title and subtitle for the chart. Next, I will select the label. This will serve as the x-axis. The label name should be in the first row of my selection. For instance, in my example, month will be the label name, and on the x-axis, I will have the months from January to March. With that said, next I will choose the data I want to plot. Similar to the label, the first row should include the label name. And that's about it. If I now click on Create Chart, the data will be sent to my Fast API app where I create the chart. The response will be the HTML code, which VBA will save in a local file. Now I have an HTML file saved in my workbooks directory, and the chart looks like this. I've got my title, and right off the bat, the chart is fully interactive. So I can hide certain products and hover over the bars to see the labels. When we look in my folder, we can see the HTML file that contains the chart. And this file is just 9 kilobytes, making it easy to attach it to an email, for example. In addition to the HTML file, you will also find a JSON file, which I will discuss in a moment. But for now, let me place the chart and my Excel data next to each other to show you some other options. As before, I will insert a title and select my data. This time, however, I will show you additional settings you can change. You can adjust the color theme, data label options, or a label format. Additionally, I will select bold labels and rotate it to create a horizontal chart. When I now generate the chart, it looks like this, which I think looks pretty neat. Next, I would like to show you the other chart types, like a line chart. As before, I will select my data, but this time I will go for the vintage theme and add a data zoom. Once generated, you can see the updated chart. Now with the additional data zoom, you can slice the data. Other options are also available, like smoothing the line or turning it into an area chart. Next, let's create a pie chart. Once my data is selected, I will change the theme again and generate the chart. Here I can toggle on or off the different categories. If you want, you can enrich the labels and create a donut plot. Now we can also see the percentage next to the number. This percentage automatically updates if you add or remove categories. Up next, we have a simple table. This isn't very exciting, but when creating the dashboard later on, it might be useful to also include a data table. Here I'm simply selecting a data range. Unfortunately, PieCharts doesn't have any customization options for a table, so when I generate it, it looks like this. Finally, the last chart type is a scatterplot. I'm currently still working on this one, so the settings aren't functional yet. And these are all the chart types I have been working so far. Since I kept the output file name the same, the chart.html file was constantly overwritten. But if you look in my folder, you will notice that each time I created a chart, the add-in generated a JSON file for me. These JSON files contain the data needed to make the chart, along with the settings you have chosen. Now, here's the cool part. Using these files, you can now create an entire dashboard. So, when I click on the dashboard icon, I am presented with the following form. Here I can select the JSON files we created earlier. By default, the tab name in the dashboard will be the chart title. However, you can change this by selecting a file and entering a new tab name here. Additionally, you can also change the order of the tabs using the move up or move down buttons. Once done, I click on generate charts. And now we have a complete dashboard. Each tab now contains one chart. This is also why I added the table as a chart type, because I think having the data source available in the dashboard might be helpful. Alternatively, you can also place all the charts in a single page. If you also select the draggable layout, you can move the charts around. However, for now, if you reopen this file, the charts will return to their default positions. So I'm still working on saving the layout once you have positioned your charts. And if we go back to my folder, we can see that this entire dashboard has a size of 53 kilobytes. Okay guys, and that is essentially the current state of the development. I plan to release the first version of the add-in in the coming weeks. I'm planning to make this add-in as a freemium, so that the add-in itself is free, but if you would like to use all features, you would need to upgrade to the paid version. But before releasing anything, I would love to hear your thoughts. What do you think about this add-in? Do you find it useful? And what kind of features would you like to see? You can be brutally honest about your opinion. Just let me know in the comments. Additionally, if you want to stay informed about the current progress of the add-in and get early access to it, you can join the waiting list on my website. Simply enter your email address here and I will keep you updated. As I've said, I'm really curious to hear your opinion. And with that, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.